So I'm Sandeepan. We are familiar with this cricket. I'm just going to talk about something like what changes in India bring about the evolution of cricket. Not a normal presentation. Is the lab is running soap opera? Why soap opera? Because a soap opera deals with anger, tears, anxiety, joy, and a time leap of 20 years to make the things like 20 saal baad isme kya ho gaya. We have actually moved into the age of T20, and that's what I'll go into a bit later. Initially, the cricket came into existence through the timeless matches. An anecdote goes through that there was a match played between England and South Africa, and England was supposed to depart on a certain date, and the match continued till 14th of March, and it was interrupted in between because they had a ship to catch from Durban, and one of the English players said, "I just have half an hour, and we would have won the match." That was the kind of things, but things developed from the timeless test matches. We moved into the 5-day test matches, and India fell in love with this kind of cricket. Why? Because India at that point of time was going through also dheere ja raha hai mera desh, and cricket was also like that. But also, it doesn't need any more equipment. You need a bat, you need a ball, and you can play it anywhere. You can play it in the dumps, you can play it in street alleys, you can play it in a number of matches, and you knowing nowhere in which match you are a part of. But in Indian sports, what happens is Indian sports do not come gradually. Means accidents happen and we come in the right place. So the first accident occurred in 1983, India winning the World Cup, followed by the post liberalization in 1992. Giants came, Pepsi, the cable car connections came, and cricket came into the households. Everyone knew about cricket, everyone was speculating about cricket. And from 50 rupees per day per test match to $20,000 per year for the central contracts. How enormous is it? Isn't it true? Accident number two happened on 25th of September 2007. India winning the T20 World Cup. Accident was that the batsman anticipated that the ball is coming a bit faster, but it helped India to break into a city leagues. Normally what happens is India are generally united on two fronts, either the Indian wall, which we normally don't like to see, and in cricket. But normally we are not acquainted with that kind of a thing. This is a city league of 6 weeks, and they are serious businessmen who are running this. And what happens is Indian Premier League earns $2.1 billion before a single ball is bowled. So that's the kind of a thing. From 50 rupees a test match, we have gone there, $2.1 billion. My God, this is something gigantic. Andrew Flintoff, in 2009, he says that at least for the 6 weeks, I am earning $1.5 million, which is much more than the favorite county league players, Gerard and Lampard, which are the highest paid footballers of their era. From where? From a simple league, from a simple club in India. It's a great thing for India, in fact. It's a really great thing. It's the player's Dwayne Bravo, we all know. I mean, this is the last slide which I'm going to tell. Initially, if we couldn't find the player, what we used to do? We would find in our localities, a subdivision, or a Ranji player. But for playing a single match, a player was transported from Kingston, Jamaica to Mumbai. India never had thought in this magnitude. Really, India had never thought. For one match, he was asked to come in a corporate jet. He said he was asked, so when do you have to reach there? So he told that we have to reach there by this. So the moment his officials said that, no, it's not about how, when you have to go, it's like when you have to reach. So, okay, you play the date X minus one, and the date X, you'll be allowed to leave. So for one match was transported from there, we can understand how much the money or the biggest population, which was our main weakness, has gained into major strength for us. This is one of the things. $2.5 billion staff coaches actually won the bidding rights, and yes, never had India back. Imagine all this magnitude. India are proud to say that cricket has been somewhere in the world. We are reaching somewhere. We are standing somewhere, and we can easily be proud of that. Thank you.